America. George Allan O'Dowd was born in Bexley Heath in Kent 22 years ago. Nowadays, he's known simply by the nickname Boy George, the singer and driving force in a pop band called Culture Club. Since the beginning of the month, they've been on tour first in Canada and now in the USA itself. And everyone seems to have taken to them, with the notable exception of the Mormons. Boy George met America head-on in Buffalo in New York State. From there, a special report from our arts correspondent, Stephen Phillips.
When Culture Club visited the States last year, they played small avant-garde clubs on the east and west coasts, with audiences of 400 or 500, and developed a minor cult following. Now they're back, selling out a 16-city tour with audiences of 15 to 20,000. Here Boy George takes a moment to compose himself before facing a packed ice hockey arena in Buffalo, the first American date of the tour. Others of the more conservative cities of Middle America, Pittsburgh, Cleveland, Detroit and Milwaukee, were to follow. And the question was, are they ready for Boy George? Singles from Culture Club's first LP have hit the American top 10, and their album sales are over 6 million. But it's the image of singer Boy George which is capturing the American imagination.
I think he's excellent. I really think he's good looking. He sings fantastic.
He's chic and he's fun and he's everything every girl likes.
I think he's wonderful. I think he's witty and his music is great, but he's very intelligent.
Oh, George, we love you!
Culture Club? Well, if you would have told me 2 years ago that I would dig like Boy George and I'd really want to come and see the show, I would have said, you know, like, shove it, you know? But, hey, I'm really up for it, you know?
Up for it, man.
It's going to be good.
Myself to be pretty masculine. I don't know whether you do, but then that's beside the point.
On a tour like this where you're playing every day and you're really in the goldfish bowl of press attention, can you ever take your makeup off, or is it actually very difficult having to be at full image the whole time?
I have to tell you, I'm the only man in Canada ever to go to a sauna in full makeup. I had a sauna yesterday and I have a steam before I go on stage, steam room, and I go on full makeup.
Doesn't it run?
No, not at all, actually. It's amazing. But the funny thing is, I mean, over there we got the news of the world, and sitting next to him, there's a lady who I heard say, I don't think his hair's very nice. You know, so it's all kind of things like that. But I've got very big ears, and I'm very sharp. I know what's going on.
As is frequently the case with idolatry, some fans can get things out of proportion.
My husband doesn't like it, but it makes me happy, so I do it anyway.
Would you be prepared to divorce your husband for Boy George?
Well, you know, he said you can't take it anymore, it's got to stop. And I told him, you know, that it makes me happy and that I'm not going to stop.
I wouldn't like to think that I got in the way of anybody's marriage, but I'm sure there are other reasons, you know what I mean? I think it's very difficult. You know, in a love affair, people always look for excuses, you know, like you're too fat or you're no good in bed anymore. And I just hope they're not using me as an excuse.
This is Lucky Mr. and Mrs. Hay, and they're going for the big Cadillac prize. Okay.
The band has a well-deserved good guy image. Whereas the big bands of the 60s used to throw TV sets out of windows, Culture Club's idea of trashing a hotel room is to take all the wrapping off the soap, and drugs are a no-no.
If we ever got stopped and there was drugs found on anything, I'd definitely leave Culture Club. You know, like Van Allen stayed in a hotel we did last night. They covered the rooms in pizzas and they left a penny for each maid. You know, that's childish. I left a note for the manager saying thank you because he left me one. You know, you give people their dignity, and I think you give people what they give you. Can I make you laugh?
Oh, I think he's sexy.
Really?
Nice.
I love him. I love him.
Everything that happens good happens in England, which is why we're here, I suppose. You know, we're taking a bit of that to America.